Jenny McCarthy Show.
Oh! Welcome back to the Jenny McCarthy Show. I'm Jenny McCarthy Wahlberg. She was on my other Jenny McCarthy Show on VH1. Now she's joining me again, Kandi Burruss. She's on Chicago, the Broadway play on Broadway, and also has a new song. Fuck yes! That's not the name of it. It's called Fake People. It's available on all digital platforms. Kandi, welcome back.
Oh, thanks for having me back.
I'm so happy. I mean, I got to talk to you for the first time when I was doing my VH1 show, and I fell in love with you. I fell in love with your sex toys.
Bedroom Kandi.
Is it still available?
Yes. Yes. Okay. Bedroom Kandi.
I still
Kandi.
Have the toys. They're all still it's working huge. Properly.
Yes. That's awesome.
We talk about sex toys a lot on the show. They're a high-end version, you guys. You're not getting like some shit toy. They're like quality.
It's definitely quality. We got awards for our products. We have an award-winning line.
Well, considering we all have award-winning pussies, why not give it something it deserves?
Yes.
So the good news is that you're here talking to me. You survived the Xscape reunion tour.
Oh, my God. Yes, I did. That's crazy. Yes,
How
I survived.
It?
It was amazing because we sold out in most of the cities that we were in. We did 29 shows. Obviously, when we first started the tour, it was, you know, we had to, you know, get used to each other. But by the end of the tour, it was all love. Yeah.
I mean, because I know what it's like. Donnie would talk to me about new kids getting back together. And there's egos on, you know, everyone has their own healthy ego.
Yeah, I forgot. You do kind of have an idea of what it's like with dealing with groups. Yeah, it's I don't want to
on tour with them.
Yeah, that tour thing can make it go crazy. But I think for the most part, we got along really well. It's just, you know, all of us are, you know, we're grown now. So it's like to put us back together after 20 years of not being together. We had to get readjusted, but I feel like, you know, we did pretty good.
You know what helps is being grateful and motivated with needing money.
Well, that wasn't my motivation.
Not for you. But for the other ones, to keep them in line, it could possibly be.
I don't think that kept people in line. I don't think so. I don't think, you know, that's so funny that you say that. I mean, you know, obviously people are like, oh, you need money. Everybody doesn't act a certain way just because of money.
I know you don't, but I know I do. When I needed speech therapy money, Mama was doing those tampon commercials. Let me tell you.
Not tampon commercials for speech therapy. That's interesting.
Not literally, but I would take some pretty bad jobs just to pay for some shit. But that's me.
And well, you know what? This was not this was what I have to say. Like, it was a very good payday. I will say, for everybody involved.
I'm so glad. And you know what? People missed you guys.
Yeah. Yeah.
People legitimately missed you.
They really did. And I don't even think we knew how much until we went on the tour. You know? We had a lot of back and forth about even doing the tour. And I was like, okay, well, if we're going to do a tour, it has to be our tour. We have to have a tour that we're headlining. And, you know, some of the girls wanted to do spot dates at first. I was like, I'm not doing that. And then some of them wanted to be on a tour where we were opening up for other people. I was like, nope, I'm not doing that. So I was like, it has to be our tour. And, you know, I helped, you know, with finding, getting the promoter on board and all this other stuff. But
You alpha'd it. We know it. You're the boss. You're the boss lady.
But it turned out to be a great situation for all of us. And just to be able to go city to city and see how many people still loved us was
right?
Amazing. It was amazing.
That's the best part. That's the fuel, I think, that keeps you going, really.
Yeah, I definitely feel like that kept us going. I mean, you know, there were
moments.
Would
you do it again?
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, I definitely would do it again. But it still would have to be the right situation. Right. And all the business has to be on point.
Right, exactly. It's got to be Kandi's way or no way.
No, I don't want to say. It's not Kandi's way or no way. You know, that's the one thing. I don't want it to seem like it's...
You're not. I'm messing with you. You don't sound like that at all.
I like things to be right, you know?
I get it.
And I don't want us to half-ass. I don't want us to not have the right...
Because you know it.
Yeah, because, you know, things will be all over the place. If you got four different people, four different opinions, it just be everywhere. You know, you got everybody has their own team, you know, trying to have a say-so. It's just too much.
You need the one alpha because Donnie is on the New Kids.
Oh, he is?
Oh, yeah. He's the one that puts all the... He puts the whole show together.
Oh, he does?
Oh, yeah. He's the creative director. He does everything.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. So I'm like, I get it because he knows. Like, so there's one that has to take charge, takes the lead. Mm-hmm. And you're the one with the knowledge.
Well, you know, we have a lot of strong personalities in the group, you know? And so sometimes we don't always see eye to eye on everything.
What would that be like on stage? I mean, that must be... I guess on stage is the easy part. It's the behind the scenes that's the hard part.
Yeah, for the most part. Yeah, because you try to keep it together on stage because you don't want the fans to not feel good energy on stage. Right. Yeah.
That, because that is a tell. And I've seen it. Chicago, now on Broadway as Mama Morton. How fucking amazing is that?
Man, when I tell you, I've always, 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 always wanted to do Broadway. Like, that was a lifelong dream. So, when I got this opportunity, I was jumping for joy. Oh, by the way, they gave me Employee of the Week.
Shut up. Is that true?
Yes, they did. Which is so funny to me. Because, you know, I've never been considered an employee or whatever, but this was pretty cool. I was like, I'm Employee of the Week.
You know,
my picture is framed on the wall.
No, it's not.
Yes, it is. I'm going to post it when I get to the theater today.
What is going on with the Housewives? What's the latest and greatest?
What ain't going on with that?
It's crazy. I mean,
this season is a lot. I mean, I think we came off of the whole big drama of the reunion last year. And so going into this season, nobody was really feeling Portia too tough. And obviously, she's had to deal with the backlash from what she... you know, brought on herself or whatever for this whole season. Everybody's like, why are y'all giving her such a hard time? I'm like, look here. Hey, man.
Those are some pretty heavy allegations.
Hell yeah. You can't just go around saying stuff like that about people. You can really, now, you know, especially nowadays. Now, it's like, you can't say that and just be willy-nilly throwing stuff out there in front of a TV camera. No, ma'am. So, yeah, she's had to deal with, you know, everybody's looking at her sideways. And so that was a lot that's been happening this season. And plus, you know, drama with everybody else, obviously.
The show has to be such a test on, like, forgiving. I mean, or being really good at putting it under the carpet and just moving on. 'Cause sometimes you just gotta. Looking at the history of the show, I've seen you evolve with some of the women where I'm like, there's no way Kandi should never be friends with her.
Right.
And then you guys figure it out.
You know what? And I think, well, the main thing is because you have to be around this person.
Right.
Like, you know, I mean, in real life, meaning off of if you're not on a TV show together, you don't have to deal with people all the time that you don't want to work with. I mean, unless y'all work together. Now, if you work with somebody, you have to see them. And it's similar. We technically work together because we're on this show together. And, you know, it's like, I guess I'm going to talk to this bitch because she's here. She's not going anywhere, apparently.
Have you met Kenya's husband at all? Is he real?
Yes. Yes. And he's a really nice guy. Good looking guy. He's really cool. He's a New Yorker.
Good.
Him and my husband, Ty, they get along great. They got a lot in common. Two Leo alpha males. And
Donnie's a Leo. So
oh, my gosh. You get it. Yeah.
They
like to tell everybody what to do. No, I am a Taurus.
I think I asked you that before because I felt like the sex stuff. You remind me of a Scorpio.
Oh, girl.
I got to ask you with the restaurant doing. How's the old lady gang doing?
Old Lady Gang is amazing. Like, we are killing it. And we're running on our running up on our first year anniversary. Will be March 17th for 1 year open. And we have killed it. Now we're about to open our second location.
I was going to say, it needs to be a chain.
Yeah, yeah. We definitely want to have like a chain. We're going
to franchise it eventually?
You never know. Maybe. Yeah. It's hard to give up control and let somebody else run with your brand. But yeah, figure it out.
And are the Old Lady Gang, are they fighting for their piece of the pie? I've always wondered how you would figure that out.
No. They're really cool.
They're good
and supportive.
Just being ambassadors?
Yeah, they're like very much so the ambassador of the restaurant. Like, they are there giving out hugs, kissing babies on every day. You know, people love that they can come there and see my family. And it's really like you came to our house for a cookout or something. You know, like, aww, the family is there. I'm here in New York now, but when I'm in Atlanta, I'm there a lot. You know, and
that's
Todd
with
is there.
Wahlburgers. If we're going to go to a city, we're going to go there and you're going to see a Wahlburg. Same thing. But the food, I want you to maybe even consider doing frozen foods. Mm-hmm. With the Old Lady Gang Southern Foods?
That's what I would love to do. I want to do that. Yes.
I know, because like, every time I see it, I'm like, oh, I want
to. I would love to be like Paul Newman, have sauces and everything in the stores with Old Lady Gang on there.
What's the must-have if anyone's going to Atlanta? What do they must-have?
Well, okay, for the appetizer, they have to have the fried deviled eggs. Those are so good. And then our Bertha's fried chicken is like the number one seller. We got the best fried chicken ever, okay?
Oh.
It's amazing. And then everything is good on our menu. I don't want to just toot our own horn, but toot toot, okay? Everything is good. And our desserts are amazing. The peach cobbler bread pudding is,
oh my god, you're making
insane.
Me so hungry. See,
as well
go.
As the bananas Foster banana pudding is insane.
I think the Super Bowl is there next year, so now I have a feeling you're gonna be pretty busy. You're gonna need at least three locations by then.
Come through.
Before I let you go, your daughter, how is she doing? Because I love watching her growth on the show, and time I remember seeing her, she was singing.
Yes, Riley is doing great. She's talking about college now and what college she plans on going to, so yeah, that's what we're trying to figure out. Right now she's on in the 10th grade, but we're making plans.
Does she want to continue singing?
She likes to sing, but she is very shy. So she's not really pushing it like how maybe I would have wanted. But, you know, you have to let your kids do what they want to do for their future or whatever. So right now her thing, because she will argue you down, she's a lawyer in the making. Yes.
But she seems like a sweetheart, and just showing her vulnerable side. And I related to you so much, being a single mom.
Thanks.
And having to work and, you know, having a dad that's not around.
Right.
And I know that was probably very challenging for you to decide to put that on TV, but it really helped a lot of us single moms feel not so alone in that.
Well, thank you. I didn't really think about it like that. That was one of the moments that I hate when they show, because I know it's a very touchy subject, you know? And just like, I guess, like the last episode people saw when her dad called and she went in the house and she cried.
Yeah.
She didn't want everybody to see her cry, so she was trying to hold her tears for when she went off, you know, camera. So that's why you don't hear her crying until the door closes. She was trying to hold it together, but
right. And then you hear you going, "What's wrong?" And I'm like, "Oh my god!" I started crying because I'm like, I can relate to that so much.
Yeah.
How is she doing with that? Like, is there advice you can give other parents?
You know, it's so hard because it's like Riley. At this point, she's built up this wall, right? And she's 15 years old now. And her dad, now he's reaching out more, but she's taking on this attitude of like, why now? You know? And she's not really open to having that relationship. And, you know, I don't really know what to do, to be honest with you. I thought about, you know, maybe we should go to counseling and do something, but she just kind of like, look, you know, I'll figure it out when I choose to, and for now I don't really want to deal with it. And so
I think it's smart then you let her decide. She's old enough almost to make that decision, right?
She is old enough to make that decision. let me just say that. But it's kind of like it's a catch 22 because I want her to have a relationship, at least for the sake of her sisters and brothers that her, you know, that she has through her father. I feel like they should have a relationship. They should know each other. They should be cool. And she's just like, throw the whole situation away.
Yeah, she's like, I ain't having it. I'll let you know.
Yeah.
I send her my love, though. I just always, when I see her on TV, I just want to give her a kiss on those cheeks and just give her a big hug.
Yeah.
She's such a sweetheart. Chicago on Broadway, there's only 1 week left, you guys. And the new song, Fake People. Is this about the Housewives by chance?
Well, bits and pieces of it, definitely. But not the entire song. Like, it's really about just not wanting to deal with people that you know aren't genuine, you know, that you know they hating on you as soon as you turn around, you know, and it's just really an anthem for that moment where you're like, man, I don't fuck with fake people. Like, get away from me.
So then definitely could be about that.
Of course.
What about when Ed Sheeran was, you're a co-writer on Shape of You. Did you know that going into
Oh, yeah. Well, okay. So he took part of No Scrubs, like the melody of No Scrubs, and used it for his song. And he reached out to us, well, his team reached out to us to let us know that before the song came out so that they could negotiate the percentage of the song that, you know, we get. And, you know,
so you'd be freaking out.
Huh?
You'd be freaking out. Like, that's awesome.
Yeah, it's more than awesome. I mean, hey, another check.
Exactly,
you know,
exactly.
And it's like the most, one of the most played songs ever last year or something like that. So
truly, I know, I was so happy for you when I heard that, and I said, you know what, that's classy, because a lot of artists will take beats or melodies and they don't do that.
Yeah, well, you know, a lot of times they try to get away with not giving credit to the original writers or whatever. So I was happy that he reached out, but what happened was we were having the conversation and then we stopped having the conversation. So I was like, okay, well, maybe he's not using the song. And then the song came out and I was like, oh, so he did use the song. Okay, so let's finish the conversation.
So then you got it finished.
Yeah.
Then you went through contract negotiations after the song came out.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, when we finished,
better.
Yeah, but I mean, let me just say, it wasn't like crazy or anything. You know,
it wasn't sloppy tea. It wasn't messy tea.
It was very much, you know, professional. And I was glad that he included us on his new project. Because obviously he's an amazing artist, amazing writer, and it's amazing.
You got great beats, and you got what you were worth. And that's what I love about you. You know your worth, and you go get it, girl. Kandi Burruss, Chicago on Broadway, Fake People. The new song's available right now on all digital platforms. And go pick up her sex toys. Thank you so much. I love seeing you, and I can't wait to come visit you.
Thank you. I hope I get to see you soon.
Jenny McCarthy Show.
Oh!